with that global world government summit. That's what it is, world government summit. There was something else he mentioned, and he was talking about news and truth. Now, he talked specifically news and truth, but he was kind of beating around the bush on a specific thing that he was talking about. Musk has talked about long-form videos and ad revenue for content creators on Twitter. What that means, and he's talking about news and truth and what he's talking about with this long-form videos and stuff, he's talking about taking on YouTube. He's talking about creating a video platform service. So he's now adding this video platform, this service into it. So long-form videos and ad revenue. Well, guess who the chick is he just hired, her specialty? Advertising, partnerships. Again, you guys seeing the connection, the role that she's going to play with all this? She has experience in all of these things that he wants to bring forth with this X app. It's very interesting, the role that she's going to play, who's also connected, again, to the WEF, which makes sense why he would, again, hire this chick. An expert from not only NBC, but also Turner Broadcasting. So this is her experience with this. Check this out. She's got 11 years experience with NBC Universal, chairman of global advertising and partnerships, chairman advertising and client partnerships, and president cable entertainment and digital advertising sales. Before that, she worked for 19 years, almost 20 years, at Turner Broadcasting as an executive vice president and COO of advertising, sales, marketing, and acquisitions. Yeah. So, she'll have expertise in the commerce thing that he wants to bring in with advertising for video platform stuff like with YouTube and all that. And it with that experience and what she's good at, it also makes sense. And here we go. This is my opportunity to talk about it. It also makes sense why Tucker Carlson is teaming up with Twitter. If you guys missed it, I'm sure you guys didn't, because Tucker's a huge talking point with this stuff. Tucker Carlson to launch version of former Fox News show on Twitter. If you guys want to check that video out, he was praising Twitter and how he wants to do his show on Twitter. Interesting. And what makes this possible, here we go, rabbit hole, hang with me. I got a lot of holes and a lot of loose ends we got to put together on this. So hang with me. What makes this possible is it's not a contract gig. Elon never offered him a contract. And so Carlson is not breaking his standing contract with Fox. That's right. He was let go of Fox, but he's still under contract with him, which means he can't take another contract. So there was that thing was, what was it? I think it was One America News Network who offered him like $100 million contract. Well, he couldn't take that if he wanted it because he's still under contract with Fox. That would be a breach of contract, but he can do something on Twitter if he's not under contract and he's just getting ad revenue through it or subscription stuff. Twitter just launched subscription. Talk about that in a second. So he won't be breaking his contract. Now, I don't believe, and I've said this before, I do not believe in quinky-dinks. This is an interesting quinky-dink with the timing of all this. You just got Tucker, who was released from Fox, who's going to be going on Twitter at the same time that Elon is hiring basically an ad expert from a TV corporation. Now that's convenient timing, and I don't believe in coincidence, but there's more to this. There's more to this. It's to be believed that the elite Rupert Murdoch was the one behind Carlson's firing or release of Fox. So that was the determination, that's what came out in the news. It was Murdoch who wanted Tucker off. He wanted him off the air. He's saying too much truth. He's saying too much damaging stuff to our narrative and all that stuff. We got to get him off. Yada, yada, yada. Free speech is bad. Not good. But what if the deal, or what if this was actually a deal made between two elites? Elon Musk seen sitting with Rupert Murdoch and Elizabeth Murdoch at this year's Super Bowl. This was in February. And as you can see, they're not forced to sit next to each other. There is plenty of empty seats behind them. You can see all those empty seats. So you've got Elon Musk here getting nice and cozy with Rupert Murdoch in February. The same Rupert Murdoch who kicked Tucker off of Fox, and it's the same Tucker that went from Fox to Twitter. At the same time, they brought in Linda, who that's her specialty. Another coincidence? You guys think so? Oh, I got more. Don't forget that the same day that Carlson was let go from Fox was the same day that CNN's Don Lemon also got let go from Fox. What's he up to? He was offered the same thing as Tucker Carlson. Elon also wants Lemon on Twitter to do a show, just like Carlson. Huh. Guys, that's a lot of coincidence. That's a lot of coincidence at the same time. Now we have to wait and see what Lemon's going to do. That was just a couple days ago. We don't know if he's going to do it. We have to wait and see. But that's interesting. You got the top guy from the right news media, and you've got the top guy from the left news media, both released on the same day, both offered shows on Twitter as well. Interesting. So you got those two guys, well-known names from right and left media, fired on the same day, and then both are connected to Twitter. And then you look at the fact that Musk and Murdoch being quite cozy. Murdoch was the one who released Tucker, so Tucker went over to Elon's Twitter. And then all of that in just a short time span, all at the same time, the new CEO is a television giant advertising specialist, is now the CEO of Twitter. Again, that is a lot of coincidence in a very short amount of time. My alarm is just going off. There's more to this. There is a lot more to this. It is one giant club, and all these guys are in it. They are all in it. They would not be allowed, and this has always been my stance with Tucker. It's always been my stance with Tucker. They would not be allowed to have these positions if they weren't allowed to. Tucker would not have been on the air as long as he was saying the things that he was saying if he was not allowed to do it. Plain and simple. You've got Fox News, who is completely compromised, and they've been compromised. They had him on the air saying the things that he did because he was allowed to. And then perfectly timed, exactly when they wanted to pull him off, they pulled him off. And now we're seeing something else being developed on that. That includes, again, Tucker as on Fox for the things that he was saying. This is important to understand, guys. It doesn't matter if what Tucker was saying was the truth or not. It doesn't matter if it was truth or not. He had a line he couldn't cross, so he could only take it so far. And then they had to hold him back right there, which he did. And he used his platform to not only stir the political pot, that's the political game that I keep talking about, guys. Divide and conquer, divide and conquer. The fact is Tucker, he stirred that political pot. The left hated him so much, and the right absolutely loves the guy. Again, it's that divide and conquer, stir the political pot, play the game. But also, he gained a mass following of people who will now join Twitter to watch his show. Now, this is where another aspect also comes in. Twitter, again, also has a subscription feature, which they just implemented like a couple weeks ago, a month ago. This is where it plays an interesting. Because in order to subscribe to get exclusive content and to support your favorite content creators, you are required to link your bank account and confirm your identity. What is the best way to all of a sudden get a whole bunch of conservatives and right-wingers all signed up with a digital identity verification system? You bring your boy Tucker on there and you offer him a subscription platform to support and or get exclusive content from him. There is always more to this stuff than what you think it is. There is always more. Always. That's why I held off on talking about Tucker, because I knew there was something more to it. I knew there was something more. Now, there could be more to it. I just haven't found it. Or I could just, maybe coincidence does exist. I don't think it does. But also with Twitter, we're almost done. But also with Twitter, don't forget that Musk is also using Twitter as a mass data collection center for his X.AI platform. I mentioned this a couple weeks ago, but I just want to go ahead and remind y'all that he bought Twitter as well as a mass data collection center, because AI requires a lot of data, information, and words to work correctly. And what is the biggest data center in the world? Twitter. And he's also founding his AI company called X.AI. There's X again. That's right. Musk, who supposedly called for a halt in AI. Remember that little thing that they put out where it's, we need to pause, put a pause on AI? Well, the same time that he supposedly signed that and put it out is the same time that he founded his new AI company. Guys, this is why I'm talking about, is you can't always take this stuff at face value. You cannot take this at face value. And if you noticed, there's been no pause in AI. Absolutely none. It was a move. And you know how many people took that and ran with it? Saying, see, Musk is for us. He's against all this AI stuff. No, he's not. Because at the same time that he's throwing that out there, he's making his own company that's going to feed off of all the Twitter data, the biggest data center out there. And that's how it's going to work. All the world's a stage. And these guys are playing their parts. Elon Musk, Linda Yaccarino, Rupert Murdoch, Tucker Carlson, Don Lemon, all these guys, they're playing their parts. That's what I'm talking about, guys. There's always more to it.